Yeah, I think, you know, our education system is also evolving, like marketing itself. So if you look at the way the kids of today are actually learning on the ground, it's very different from what they were doing even 5 years back. Online content being available, self-learning has become like the mode in which they learn. Content is accessible, content is comparatively economical for them to access as well. So all these areas have made, as actually building them up for a more agile world. They can learn at their convenience, they can learn, in the medium that they want. So all that is basically getting them to become more agile than the previous generations. And that goes well with the way marketing has evolved. So people have learned in an agile way, I'm sure they're going to be able to use that also in an agile way. So I think our education system is evolving. We just have to take cognizance of that. Sometimes we get a feeling that, you know, whatever is being done is very archaic, it's being very traditional. It's not something that the students ready for the future. I'm in strong disagreement because I think we need to know exactly how education systems are evolving. Many of us are not aware of the evolution. That's why we probably feel it's not agile enough. I think the world is evolving very fast, and education system is no stranger to that evolution. Intuition will always continue to play a part, because no matter how much of data is there, and that's what I spoke about, is it cannot predict the future, because data is all about the past, and it can point you towards how it's going to be evolving, but that's not the way the world evolves. You can look at any field, the evolution of what is coming next has never been predicted. It's never been possible. You can make intelligent guesses. Some of these guesses might turn out to be right, but I think the people who are going to be the leaders of the future will have to apply a lot of judgment coming from different sources to arrive at what's going to succeed tomorrow morning. So I feel intuition is always going to be in vogue. It's like oxygen. No matter what happens, I think we always will need that to breathe. And intuition is something which leaders will always need. The good news, of course, is that intuition is based on a lot of data which is prevailing. So it makes it a little more real, but doesn't mean that is restrictive. There's a world of difference between calling something real and something restrictive. We should not outsource intuition, because intuition is by definition inside you, and it comes from a very strong sense of judgment, which comes over looking at poring over, tons and tons of data. If we just go back to the history of all the inventions and discoveries made in the world, and some of them have been absolutely breakthrough, they've all come from looking at the past. But that did not stop the inventors or the discoverers to come up with something that is totally different, but which has got a very strong foundation in the data. So data is only helping better, develop your intuition better. What you need to realize is, no matter what you do, you're marketing and selling something or trying to impact a human being. Somebody at the end of it has to be somebody who is receiving information, is a human being. He comes with his biases, his ability, his cognitive abilities. They will always continue to be very, very important. So, as I said, it's sort of related to the question of intuition itself. It is humanizing. Our delivery of whatever we want to do will continue to be a very, very important part of it. I don't think we need to artificially try to humanize anything, because it is, I think business leaders are smart enough to see that, there is not an overuse of technology in a restrictive sense, and they will know when to humanize and what. But just because robots have come doesn't mean that a great hotel like this will stop trying to provide great human experiences. So that's how I look at humanizing it. So I think the regulations are a given. There's no question about people not following those regulations. Those regulations are meant, and I think they do good to people over a longer term. It might be tempting to break some of these rules and try to bend over and try doing things which are not compliant. I'm dead against that for the simple reason that it has a very negative impact potentially going forward. So I think when we try to personalize, I think the personalization and the legal frameworks provide enough of enough width for you to do whatever you want to do without having to violate anything. I think the only thing which limits you is your own imagination about how you want to personalize it. You know, I wish I could have given a very innovative answer, but I don't. I think the challenge is, to me, I think the only role that brand managers and marketers always perform is to provide a differentiated offering to the market. I don't know whether that has changed at all, no matter how the world around us has changed. In fact, I would say that the role to differentiate has only gone up because the competition is coming from so many different sources. So I think it's about how do you provide differentiated offering. One change, however, though, that it's become that much more difficult to get the attention of your customers and consumers. In that scenario, I think providing a differentiated offering is a challenge for marketers as always. In fact, more than what it was in the last